Have you been taking part in the Octopus Saving Sessions, also known as DFS or Demand Flexibility Service? If you're not with Octopus, then your supplier might have a different name for it. I think E.on Next calls it Energy Shift and OVO is calling it Power Move. Whatever it's called, I have a problem, and that problem is my battery, which has a tendency to run out of charge during the winter before these sessions begin. Well, I have a solution in the form of an automation, of course. Having a home battery like mine, which is an 8.2 kilowatt hour GivEnergy one, is great. In theory, during these saving sessions, my battery should be able to cover our use and we'd draw absolutely nothing from the grid at all for those periods. The problem is that my 8.2 kilowatt hour GivEnergy battery just doesn't have enough capacity to get me through a full day during the winter with its lack of sunshine. So by the time we get to the evening when the saving sessions normally take place, I've got no capacity left. I found myself estimating how much capacity I'd need to get through the session, and then manually pausing the battery's discharge before I got to that threshold. Just before the session begins, I'd resume it again. This involved a lot of clock watching, and it got me thinking, can I automate this? Of course I can. I came up with an automation for Home Assistant, which I then turned into a blueprint to make it easier for anyone to install. It essentially watches your battery percentage to make sure it doesn't drop below the percentage that you want reserved for the saving session. If it does drop too low, it'll pause the discharge and resume it again just before the session starts to make sure you don't draw anything from the grid. I'm going to make a massive assumption here that you already have your GivEnergy battery connected to Home Assistant. If you don't, then I'll put a link in the description to another video I made which will talk you through that whole process. You're going to need to create some helpers before we can configure the blueprint, and you do that in Settings, Devices and Services, and Helpers. I'm going to filter by Octopus and show you the ones that I've already created. This first helper is a date time helper, but set for date only. This will be used to store the date of the upcoming saving session. The second and third helpers are also date time helpers, but set to time only. One will store the start time of the saving session. The other is for the end time. The fourth and final helper is a number helper. This is set to have a minimum value of 1 and a maximum value of 100 and a unit of measurement of percentage. You'll use this helper to set how much battery capacity you wish to reserve per hour for the saving session. Now it's time to install the blueprint. The easy way is to visit my website, which I'll put a link to in the video description. In the article for this video, you'll find a button to click on, which should download and install the blueprint for you automatically. Alternatively, I'll show you the manual method now. You need to copy and paste the source code from the same article into a YAML file. Save that file somewhere obvious and then make sure you have the file editor add-on installed in Home Assistant. Open the file editor add-on, then navigate to your config folder, which I'm already in. Go to Blueprints, Automation, and then click on the Upload File button. Click on File, choose the YAML file, and click on OK. You'll need to reload your automations before you can use it, so you do that in Developer Tools and click on Automations. Next, we need to create the automation itself. You go to Settings, Automations and Scenes, and click on Create Automation. We're going to use a blueprint here, so choose Octopus Saving Session for GivEnergy from the drop-down list. You'll then be presented with a lot of drop-down boxes, which I promise you is a lot easier to use than having to dive into the automation configuration manually to change all of the various entities. I'm trying to be nice to you all here, so let's go through them all one by one. First, choose the entity that gives you your current battery percentage. It might be something like sensor.givetcpsoc. So if I search for SOC here, I'm actually going to choose that one. Now choose the four helper entities that you created earlier. So you've got one for the day, you've got one for the start time, one for the end time, and then battery percentage per hour. Scroll down a little bit here. We then need to tell the automation which switch entity controls the enabling and disabling of battery discharge. We're looking for the one called enable discharge. That one there. And finally, the automation needs to know which mode the battery is currently in. GivTCP has a select entity called mode, which we'll be using. I'll choose that there. Basically, the automation will be checking to see if the battery is in eco mode or not. Eco mode means that it's discharging to your home, so hopefully preventing you from drawing from the grid. Save the automation and give it a nice name. I'm going to call it saving session and save. There's one final step to get this working, and that is adding those helpers you created to your dashboard for easy access. You can present this however you want, but this is just a demonstration. So you can edit your dashboard, click on Add Card, choose Entities, and then you want to delete these pre-filled ones here. And I'm going to search for the Octopus saving session day, Octopus start time, Octopus can't type, end time, and then percentage per hour, and click on save, and done. You'll end up with this nice simple card, and filling in the first three items should be pretty straightforward. You just set the times in here. Now, calculating how much energy you'll need to get you through the saving session is a bit trickier. I guess the non-scientific way of doing this is by keeping an eye on your typical usage during the evenings. When I take part in a saving session, I still try to shift the usage around a bit to minimise what I'm using then anyway, in order to prevent any power spikes which would cause me to draw from the grid before the battery has had a chance to ramp up. So I avoid using the oven, the kettle and things like that. If you'd like to be a bit more scientific, then I work on a background power of 600 watts during the session, which is 0.6 kilowatt hour per hour. My battery is 8.2 kilowatt hours, but I reserve 10% of that in case of a power cut, which gives me 7.4 kilowatt hours. 0.6 kilowatt hours is just over 12% of that usable capacity. I err on the side of caution and set the battery percentage per hour slider to 15%. Behind the scenes, the automation will work out how much is required for the saver session based on the length of that session. So if you have a 1 hour session scheduled, that would be 15% reserved plus an extra 15% just in case. So it won't let your battery drop below 30% before the session begins on that day. If you have a 2 hour session, then that would be 30% reserved plus an extra 15% just in case, and your battery won't be allowed to drop below 45% until the session begins. Anyway, don't forget that all of the configuration is going to be available on my website, and the link to that is going to be in the description. I hope you find this useful, and if you did, then please give the video a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.